time.
Time for what?
For YSTV's first program.
I thought we were watching the news.
No. YSTV's first colour program. 6 o'clock Monday. That's what we're watching.
It's 2 minutes past.
Typical YSTV. Always late.
Primary colour and a new term on YSTV. And as you can see, for the first time in our 19-year history, we're in red, blue and green. So how did we manage it? Well, as Kath Grinstead explains, it's all down to three very important factors. Time, effort and...
In March this year, YSTV decided to try and move to colour broadcasting. The major problem, as with any society, was finance. Despite its relatively large budget, YSTV could not afford to finance such a scheme itself, so it was decided to approach the university and ask for help. The Vice-Chancellor was interested and very supportive. A donation was offered to YSTV, as well as an interest-free loan to cover the large cost involved.
The man from Hess Hall, he said, yes.
Had to be put to the Students' Union because they were the people who would eventually have to guarantee any loan. So in May, YSTV asked the Students' Union to accept a loan from the university. The complications and ramifications for the union budget had to be considered, and at two union executive meetings, the proposals were discussed in great detail, ending, we are happy to say, in agreement.
So, over the summer, YSTV dismantled the entire black and white setup, purchased all the new equipment that was needed for a basic colour studio, upgrading the network in the process with new monitors, and constructed a brand new control room. And this is what it looks like now. During a live programme, four or five people can sit at this desk here and operate sound, vision, video and computer equipment. The nitty-gritty of the operation is all inside this 19-inch equipment rack, and the live program you're watching at this moment is being controlled from here. And believe it or not, it's not that difficult.
Well, that's it for tonight. We hope you've enjoyed our first colour program and that your interest in YSTV has been further awakened. This Friday, YSTV's first newscast hits the air, and before long, a liberal sprinkling of feature items will enliven your mealtimes. Please keep an eye out for them, and in the meantime, Grapevine will provide a mine of information. But for now, from Steve and myself, good night.
That's the most expensive student TV programme ever made.
Really?
Yep.
How much did it cost?
£6,000.
£6,000?
Yeah.
What a blimey waste of money.